guys, Joey here, FugaTech. And just because 2019 is over doesn't mean that the phones from last year are irrelevant now. Today, we're going to be recapping the best entry-level phones from 2019. This list is in no particular order except the last item, which will be our favorite top pick for entry-level smartphones in 2019. Starting with the Redmi Note 7. Now, this was one of the most popular entry-level phones in the beginning of 2019. And a huge part of that was thanks to its 48-megapixel main rear camera, as well as its low price. And rightly as such, next up we have the Redmi Note 8. Just like its predecessor, in the second half of 2019, it was one of the most popular smartphones in the entry-level segment, if not the most popular. From Note 7 to Note 8, Redmi was able to improve the different aspects, including design, display, chipset, even the cameras. Next up, we have the Realme 3. Again, so this was one of the most popular entry-level smartphones from early 2019. It became one of the cheapest smartphones to sport a MediaTek Helio P60 chipset because the previous year, that was more of a mid-range chipset. And yeah, because of that good price to specs ratio, it deserves a spot on this top list of entry-level phones. Next up, we have the Realme C2 2020. For that low price, you were able to get a pretty solid design, decent enough entry-level specs in that Helio P22 chipset, and okay cameras as well. Next up, we have the Oppo A5s. You can look at this phone as a kinda bit upgraded Realme C2 2020 because it's powered by a MediaTek Helio P35 chipset. We get similar cameras, display, and battery, but at the same time, it's also priced a little bit more expensive. But still, it's a good entry-level phone and definitely one of our favorites from last year. Next on the list is the Vivo Y17. Now, this one is also kinda like the A5s. It's also powered by a Helio P35 chip, but it's priced a little bit more expensive at almost 11,000 pesos. But with that price increase, you do get better cameras, a bigger battery, bigger storage options, and a bigger screen as well. At number 2, we have the Samsung Galaxy A20. Now, the entire Galaxy A series from 2019 is definitely one of our favorite series from the entire year. And the Galaxy A20 is surely a big part of that. Of course, for an entry-level phone, it gives you a Super AMOLED display. You get the Exynos 7884 chipset. You have dual cameras, 4000mAh battery. And of course, our favorite skin here in the office, One UI. And now, finally, the YugaTech team's favorite entry-level smartphone of 2019, we have the Realme 5. For a very low starting price of only 6,990 pesos, you get a Qualcomm Snapdragon 665, you get a quad camera setup at the back, you get a pretty good display, huge 5,000mAh battery, and just generally good value for your money. You've seen our reviews, you've seen our comparisons, you guys already know why. The Realme 5 is our favorite smartphone from the entry-level segment in 2019. Now I'm passing the question off to you guys. Which of the entry-level smartphones from 2019 is your favorite? Let us know in the comments down below. And if you enjoyed this video, please do drop a like, subscribe to our channel for more content, hit the bell icon so you don't miss any future uploads, and be sure to visit yugatech.com for the latest tech news and reviews. This has been Joey, and stay hydrated. Stay hydrated.